This type of Hess's Law question has tricked so many students on exams, but it's not going to trick you. Hello everyone, I'm Melissa Maribel, your personal tutor, and for this question, we will find the enthalpy change of that top reaction by manipulating the three bottom reactions to look like that top reaction, which is our goal. Starting with our first reactant, CH4, we'll look and see where CH4 is in the below reactions. And it is not on the correct side, so we will flip the reaction. Whenever you flip a reaction, you must multiply the enthalpy change by a negative 1. So our enthalpy change is now positive. On to the second reactant, NH3. Now, NH3 is on the wrong side, and there are too many NH3s. We just want one, and we actually have two so far. So we will multiply the entire reaction by 1/2, which is the same thing as dividing everything by 2. And we will flip the reaction. So since we multiplied by 1/2 and flipped the reaction, we must multiply by a negative 1/2 to our enthalpy change, and we'll get this new value. Now to our first product of HCN. This is on the correct side, but once again, we have too many. In order to make this 2HCN a 1, we will multiply the entire reaction by 1/2 and multiply the enthalpy change by 1/2 as well, and we'll get this new value. Looking at that 3H2 on the product side, you'll notice that H2 is actually in every single below reaction. So we won't change anything else on our below reactions. Instead, we will add up all the reactions together and check how many H2s we are left with at the end. By adding all the reactants together and all the products together, we get this reaction. Let's check how many H2s we are left with. Looking at the product side, we can add the H2s together since they're like terms on the same side. Let's do this math separately. We will add 3/2 and 2 together. When adding fractions, remember we need a common denominator, which is 2. This 2 is actually divided by 1, so we will multiply the top and the bottom by 2. Next, add straight across and we get 7/2. Then subtract the amount of H2s we have on the reactant side from those we have on the product side, or really 7/2 minus 1/2, and we get 6/2, which can reduce down to 3. This worked out nicely because in the goal reaction, we wanted 3 H2s. Now this is our new reaction and we can cancel out more like terms. We will cancel the carbons on either side and we can cancel the N2s as well. We then get our goal reaction, and now we'll add up all the new enthalpy changes together. And this is our total enthalpy change of the reaction.
I have another Hess's Law video that can really help prepare you for your next exam. If this video helped, make sure to give it a thumbs up, and I'll see you in the next video.